Okay, number one, what are at least two thoughts that come to your mind when you see school board members harassed, attempts are made to recall them, like in Scottsdale, they didn't work, or there are school board members and candidates who embrace vaccine denialism or not letting children find out the truth of the nation's history? I think there's a couple of board members in Litchfield that are like that. So please respond.
Yes, David. I think that is unacceptable, and it's not reflective of where we are in American history and what we should actually be doing. And so it's easy for us to be divisive. And so we need to identify a common ground in order to move forward for the sake of our children, because our children are depending on us to be successful, and we're not doing a great job of that right now.
Number two, with regards to school board candidates, please tell the readers what are at least two electoral goals of future leaders of Arizona.
Yes, for future leaders of Arizona, we definitely want to recruit more women and more people of color to run for school boards, because we do have a lot of people that are on the school board, but they're not really reflective of the demographic that they represent. For instance, if I look at Levine School Board is very diverse in their population, but their school board, the governing board, is not. And so I would love for our governing boards to reflect the communities that they represent, and therefore we may find a more inclusive governing boards when we do that.
Is there, other than obviously winning, any other electoral goals that you would like to pursue in addition to diversity?
I think diversity is the main thing, because for one, we know that right now, you know, school boards are nonpartisan, so I don't really have any Democratic goals for it, other than ensuring that Michelle Eugenie Rita bill is not passed, making school boards partisan.
Right. Understood. Excellent. And as a sub question, is future leaders solely focused on school board candidates? Are you recruiting for, say, Justice of the Peace? Are you recruiting for any other county offices, or is school boards the main focus right now?
Yeah, David, school board is the main focus for us, because for Maricopa County, I've said, I think we did an interview right when I came on or shortly after, and we talked about bottoms up.
Yes, and we did.
So with us focusing on bottoms up, school board is at the bottom of my ballot. So it goes in hand, in tandem with what we're doing at the county, which is building from the bottom up. And so for us, school board is at the bottom, so we can't focus on anything else but the bottom of our ballot as we build. I mean, I would love to see other programs come apart, or maybe we add in addition, but we all know the importance of school board, and we all know what's at stake for the school board. And so we don't have the capacity to add roots to the trees until we're solid in school board, solid in our.
And as a quick follow-up, this is K-12 and Maricopa County Community College.
Yes, it is. It's governing and in college. Yes.
Okay, very good. Number three, please tell the readers the number of candidates you're looking to recruit and the names of districts you will support candidates running in. Is this for all the school districts, or are you focusing on, like you mentioned, Levine before, are you focusing on several districts and just those, and how many candidates are you looking to recruit?
Yes, we're looking to recruit between 28 and 36 new people. And when I say new, I'm not talking about the people that are in our political diaphragm, right? I'm talking about people that never even thought about running for school board, that even considered even being in politics. I'm looking for coaches, school bus drivers. I'm looking for unconventional candidates for the governing board. And so we're looking for about 28 to 36. And support for us is making sure that they're tied into our communities so that our communities can support them, because we are limited on the Democratic side of what we can do when it comes to nonpartisan races.
The second part of the question, are there districts that you are isolating or choosing?
Yeah, we're looking at targeting. We have Chandler, of course. We need to do something in Scottsdale, because Scottsdale is so crazy. It should not be that crazy in Scottsdale.
Yeah, I understand.
Chandler, Scottsdale, Litchfield Park, Peoria, Levine. So those are some of the Republican districts, but it also depends on what the redistricting looks like as well. Course. That will play a part, but right now it's Levine, it's Chandler, it's Peoria, it's Litchfield Park.
Is Tempe or Gilbert or Glendale or not the cycle?
No, we're not looking at Tempe. Tempe has a very progressive governing board, so we don't even need to touch them. If anything, we need to ensure that those people maintain their seats, and that's a different conversation of insurance. But whoever they get in Tempe, it will fall in line with Tempe. They're usually reflective. And that board is very diverse. There's a great on that board. So yeah, we won't focus Tempe. We may look at Mesa. I know that we have a couple people running for their seat again. I think it's Marcy Hutchison. So.
Okay. And Kiana Sears is on that board too, right?
Yes, but Kiana's not up until 2024. She just ran in 20.
Please describe at least two ways the Maricopa County Democratic Party will help their and maybe this is an unfair question. Help their preferred school board candidates prevail.
It's a fair question. Ensuring that they're tied into our communities, tied into people that can be successful in helping them with school boards, because we know that it does not take hundreds of thousands of dollars to win these school board seats. Most of these school boards are, won with, $5,000, $6,000, So getting them tied into our community and actually having the community be involved in school board is a change we're looking to make, because right now it's not the community that's involved at the grassroots level. And so for me, it's ensuring that our community is reflective in the governing board members, because the thing is, we're not choosing them. We're just showing them that there's an avenue to being successful with helping out with our children's education.
Okay, no problem. Hey, one quick follow-up on both questions. How many, you mentioned 28 to 38. How many have you recruited so far?
So far, I think we're close to, and we launched in November.
Right.
I think that we're closer up to 20. And so we have paid media that's running on this as well. So we had a whole communication plan, a communication team that they launched our ads and things like that. So we've been very intentional about the work that we're doing on school boards.
Very good. Very good. Okay. Excellent. Number five, please describe at least components of the school board candidates' campaign program they will run on. I'm assuming there are three common themes.
Yeah, there are common things, but I think it doesn't differ too much from what we want to see on the Democratic side anyway. And one of that is equity, transparency, and just communication. Like, those are the three basic principles, So we need to talk about equity, but we also need to be transparent. Like, there are a lot of things that are going on in our school boards, like when it comes to vendor contracts, when it comes to superintendent salaries, when it comes to curriculum and policy, those conversations need to be transparent. And then we won't have things like CRT being successful in national news, because yeah, there's clear communication that's going on in the grassroots.
Do you want to make an on-the-record comment on CRT?
Sure, I can make an on-the-record comment about critical race theory. What I'll say is, I don't have anything to say because it's not real.
Okay.
That's my on-the-record. And I tell my team all the time is that when we respond to things that are untrue, then we're fanning the flames, okay, right? So what is our message? So that's why when you ask me, what are you talking about? Equity, communication, transparency. Okay. Those are things that we have to do, because can't respond to Republican messaging. Right. And they're like, well, the Democrats' message. Well, we're not messaging. We're responding to messages. That means that our message is not being heard.
No, I understand. But if I may be permitted a quick follow-up on that, if a candidate gets asked at a debate, for example, they're going to be asked about CRT. They're going to be asked about their position on vaccine quarantines, vaccine mandates, or, what would you advise them to say in that regard? Because they are going to get the question.
Yeah. And so CRT and vaccine mandates are two different things, right?
Right.
It's policy. And so for me on CRT, I'll be honest with you, David, I don't want them responding to CRT because CRT is not real. It's not accurate. And so I think my favorite thing is that I always talk about when Senator McCain, when he got the question from the audience and the ladies asked him, she was like, well, how do you feel? Are you going to ask for Obama's birth certificate? And his response was, no, we're not going to do that. We're not going to do that. He's a citizen. He just walked away. Right. He didn't engage. He didn't do any of that. And so for me, taking Senator McCain's approach on, like, we're not going to address these things that are not true. Like, I'm not going to allow you to carry this rumor because it does not do anything for American democracy.
That's actually a pretty good answer to the question. So, yeah, for a candidate to say that works. Number six, is there anything not covered in the first five questions that you'd like the readers to know about the school board recruitment program?
Yes, we need every day average people running for school board, whether you have kids or whether you don't have kids. You can be a school bus driver. You can be an aunt. You can be a cousin. You can be anything. We just want people that care about children and that are going to fight like hell to protect our children and ensure that they have the education that they deserve.
Okay. Excellent. Excellent.